Resilience comes from the word resiliere, which means to leap back. And resilience is the ability to bounce back after defeats and disappointments, the positive adaptation after adversity. And it is one of the key factors to become a great athlete, because it helps you get back after defeat, which is a key part of sport as well. Research has indicated that resilience protects our mental and our physical health by reducing stress. So, how can you unlock your resilience? First, we have to understand what psychological mode we are in. When you're getting to the tight moments of a match in the court, your mind can switch to the default setting of survival instinct. In this setting, we narrow our thinking to what is only in front of us. We forget the big picture. And this over-concentration often leads to mistakes. In such turmoils, you can unlock your power of resilience to make your mind your friend. Resilience can be built and practiced via skills and behaviors, and these resilience skills allow you to mentally and emotionally overcome crisis in moments of sport, adversities, during match, or even across careers. Resilience helps you survive and thrive. So here are three effective research-based strategies to train your resilience to prepare for when you are back on the court and be psychologically resilient. Firstly, practice physical distancing, but don't forget to be socially connected. As human beings, our power of resilience depends on the strength of our social support. Stay in touch with your support system, create new ones, help each other through these times, and you will increase your resilience. Use social media responsibly. Call your friends who you have lost connection to due to not playing sport. Spend time with your family. If you are watching this, you have already reached out to your club via social media. So great going. Keep calm and reframe. That's the second point. And it is normal to overthink and worry. It is normal to feel tightness and tension in your body in crucial match points or crucial times. Be aware of what you are feeling so that you know what is coming up in you, within you. Breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth, gently. Repeat this breathing till you can feel your heartbeat. When you can feel your heartbeat, observe your thoughts and try to catch them. Once you catch them, try to turn the thoughts around. For example, I cannot go to the tennis court can be reframed as, let us try doing wall rallies. Or, my children cannot go to training can become, I can help them train and spend quality time with them like I've always wanted to. Take a step away from the news cycle, not be immersed in every breaking news alert. If you want to take it further, there are several apps such as Calm and Headspace, which are examples which you can use, which will help you control your breathing and be in the moment. Positive reframing allows us to take that step back, reframe the events, allowing us to be better, adapt better in any and all adversities. Third, take charge. Mastery and control build resilience. To build mastery, you need to identify what you can control and what you cannot control. For example, I cannot go out to play sports, but I can do sporting challenges at home. Roger Federer's wall challenge, brilliant example of that. Once you have identified what you can and cannot control, focus only on the things that you can control. Reflect upon the things you always wanted to do, but only now have the time and space to do it. Read that book you bought at the airport but never read. Gather resources to hone your sport micro skill at home. Build specific muscle groups by doing home exercises. Stay fit. Having control over your actions builds environmental mastery, which is your control about what is around you, and therefore makes you resilient. Begin each day by asking yourself, what can I do that is meaningful to me? And that thing can be as big or as small as you want it to be. It is something that is meaningful for you. So in summary, to build your resilience, be physically distanced while being socially connected. Keep calm, take charge, and reframe to find your resilient self.